Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on the truth about using cheap gas in your vehicle. A lot of the times you might hear people throw around the terms cheap gas or premium or high quality gases. So what does that really mean? There are three different ways to break down cheap gas or higher quality gas, and that's looking at the actual price, the actual quality of the fuel, as well as the octane rating. Starting off directly, talking about price and quality of fuels, all fuel in the US is regulated, and when it leaves the refineries, it's all going to be very, very similar quality. The major difference in fuel quality comes after it leaves the refineries, and it really boils down to the additives and detergents that some fuel companies and fuel brands put in their gasoline. These detergents and additives can help keep your engine a lot cleaner and prevent any kind of sludge buildup or issues. There's even a fuel rating called top tier, which is trademarked in a lot of different brands and companies support. These top tier fuels, you will see that on the pump. They are held to a slightly higher quality standard when it comes to the detergents and additives used in the fuel, and they're also independently tested for performance. And so essentially, this just guarantees the highest quality gas that you can find around. When it comes to these top tier approved fuels, most major US fuel brands will meet this classification. That includes things like Conoco, Phillips 66, Sunoco, Exxon, Mobil, Chevron, Shell, Kirkland Signature, and many more. They're definitely going to be among the most premium top quality fuels available, and sometimes that might mean that they're going to be a little bit more expensive than cheaper fuels. And a lot of the times these cheaper fuels don't have these same additives, and a lot of the times you'll find them maybe at smaller gas stations or unbranded gas stations where they're just getting their own fuel from the local refineries or the closest one possible and not really adding many additives or doing much to the fuel and just selling it as is. But I'll circle back to that in just a moment. When it comes to these top tier fuels and any of these fuels that are approved, it certainly doesn't hurt to price shop. When it comes to using fuels that don't meet the top tier approval, it can be slightly worse in the longer term to use those cheaper gases. It's likely not going to cause any damage, and if you're really saving enough at the pump, it could be worthwhile to use those fuels. However, it's also not a bad idea to use some of these higher quality gasolines that do have the additional additives and run a couple tanks of that through your engine from time to time just to ensure that you are getting the best possible cleaning and the best possible fuels to keep your engine healthy and safe for the longer term. So something to consider there, but ultimately a lot of the times this cheap gas is still regulated and approved for sale here in the US. So it's not like any of this cheap gas is going to instantly harm your engine. It's just that some of these higher quality fuels can help keep your engine a little bit cleaner, and that can lead to better reliability and lower maintenance in the longer term of your engine. Moving on to the third thing is octane rating. Now this is somewhat separate. I just wanted to throw this in to point out that octane rating is something that's very important, and you shouldn't try to save money at the pump by running lower quality fuels than your engine calls for. So if you have a vehicle that requires 91 octane, you shouldn't go around filling up on 85 octane just to save money at the pump. On the other hand, if you have a vehicle that only requires something like 85 or 87 octane, there's no real reason or benefit to fill up on 93 octane, and you're likely not going to see any notable differences in performance. Those octane ratings really don't have anything to do directly with fuel quality so much as just the fuel's ability to withstand knock and detonation events. So ultimately, point there is octane ratings don't really tie into this conversation about cheap gas very much. Just ensure you are running the proper octane for your engine. So in summary about the truth of using cheap gas in your car, cheap gas is often totally safe. It's not going to cause any issues with your vehicle, especially in the shorter term or if you're just filling up on it on a road trip or occasionally just to save a little bit of money at the pump. But higher quality fuels, and especially those that are top tier approved, do offer higher quality additives and detergents, which can be better for your vehicle's maintenance and reliability in the longer run. So these quality fuels can help save you some money in the long term of owning a vehicle. But again, cheap gas isn't necessarily bad for your car and likely isn't going to cause any significant harm. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.